Welcome back to Science Hub. I will be Patience Mogori.
Gizma Steven.
And Swankari.
Today I'll be taking you to the cell. The cell is a basic functional unit of an organism. The cell are microscopic and make up the structure of living organism and are responsible for carrying various biological processes. Organisms that compose of a single cell are called unicellular, and organisms that compose of many cells are called multicellular, e.g. maize, human beings, and cows. Cells are very small and can only be seen using a microscope. Cell organelles are structures found within a cell. A light microscope. Here is an example of a light microscope. This is an instrument that is used to magnify and reveal structure of tiny object cells. As we have said before, cells are very small units, and they can be enlarged by a microscope. That is the light microscope. Generally, a microscope magnifying images objects where final details are required. This light microscope, it gives us the final details where it is required. A microscope is designed to give the final details of objects that will not be seen by naked eyes or hand lens. This microscope, it has been designed to help us see small organisms that you cannot see by our naked eyes. The light microscope is commonly used in schools because it uses light for illustration of specimen to be viewed. It's used in school because it's cheaper than electric microscope and it uses light, it doesn't use electricity. So there's no much of electricity to be used, we just use light. This microscope is very delicate and expensive instrument. It should be handled with care. My partner will take you to the next.
Handling and caring for microscope. One rule to be observed. Always use both hands, and when carrying a microscope, one hand should hold the base to provide support while the other hand hold the limb.
This is the base. You one hand to hold the base and the other one to hold the limb. This is the base.
Point number two. Never place the microscope too closer to the edge or of the working bench or a table.
As Alul is saying, you never place this light microscope near the bench or the working table. You should put it in the middle, because this is an expensive thing. You should not place it here, because it can fall down, it can break.
Point number three, do not touch the mirror and the lens with your fingers.
This mirror, the lenses, and the eyepiece should not be touched by your mirror. They might cause that in which what you will be looking for will not get what you want exactly. It will catch the mirror, the objective lens, and the eyepiece.
Point number four, never. Dirty lens should be cleaned using a special soft lens tissue paper or tissue paper moisture with ethanol.
Here with me I have ethanol. This is ethanol. I'll pour it into my beaker. Here is our tissue paper. So as they say, dirty lenses should be cleaned with special soft lenses tissue paper moistened with ethanol. So we'll place our tissue paper in the ethanol. As we leave it to moisten, then the lenses should be wiped using an ethanol.
The mirror.
These lenses that we use, and also our mirror. We'll have to use our ethanol to wipe. Never ever use any wet material to wipe the lenses. It should only use a tissue paper and the ethanol.
Point number 5. Other part of the microscope may be clean using a soft cloth or tissue paper.
Yeah, as we have said, we should use a tissue or a cloth, but not a wet cloth.
Do not wet any part. Do not wet any part of the microscope.
This microscope should not be wet. Wetted when, for example, we're splashing water into it. It should only be used by ethanol to be wiped. For example, for instance, you might splash water into the objective lenses. You should carefully wipe it with a tissue paper or a cloth, a piece of cloth.
Make sure the lower power objective lens click into position in lens with the eyes piece before and after use.
Okay, this is the revolving eyepiece. It is used to turn this objective lens. So you must make sure this the raw objective lens click when you want to view under it. You just turn like this, and then to click you hear a sound. Yeah, that one.
Then lastly but not least, after use, always clean and store the microscope in a safe place, free from moisture and dust.
Our microscope should be stored in a well-placed area, free from dust and moisture. Yeah.
My friend will take over through function of part of a microscope.
We have functions of parts of a microscope. We have got rib. Rib is used to support the body tube and stage.
Here is a limb. It's used to support the body tube and the stage.
We have base. Base provide firm and steady support.
Here is the base. Base to make it, you can put it here, then it is stand firm. Because if it doesn't have this base, it cannot stand, it will fall.
Then we have body tube. It holds the eyepiece and removing loose piece.
This is the body tube. It holds this revolving eyepiece and the nose. This is the body tube. It holds this revolving nose piece.
In our microscope, we have two adjustment knob. We have got fine adjustment knob and we have coarse adjustment knob. When we come to fine adjustment knob, it raises and lowers the body tube to draw smaller distances to bring the image into focus.
This is the coarse adjustment knob. Yeah, it's a movable part. It can move up and it can move down.
When we come to coarse adjustment knob, it raises and lowers the body tube for large distances to bring the image into focus.
This is the movable.
The fine knob. The fine adjustment knob.
Yeah, and then we come to eyepiece. Eyepiece contain lenses which concentrate with magnification of a specimen.
Here it is the eyepiece. You can even see and then you look through that object that you are studies. You can see, you see clear it.
And then we have three objective lenses. They bring image into focus.
The three objective lenses are, we have one that is, let's see, we have one that is four, and we have another one that is 25, and we have another one that is 40. These are the nose, revolving nose evolving those pieces.
We have in microscope, we have got a mirror. It reflects light through condenser.
This is the mirror. This is the mirror because the darks you cannot see when it is dark, but this mirror, you will take it where there's a light so that it will reflect light and then you will see you are observing very well.
We have revolving nose piece. Hold objective lenses in place, enabling the change from one revolving piece to another one. Objective lens to another one.
These are the revolving.
I mean this one. Revolving nose piece. We have got condenser. It concentrates light and object on the stage. Condenser is under here. We have the stage. Stage is flat platform where specimen on the stage is pressed. And this is the stage. We press our specimen here and that we can observe.
Using the microscope. Place on a bench with the stage facing away from you.
You place the facing away from you. Just a little bit like that.
Turn the lower objective lens until it clicks into position.
The lower objective lens is transformed. You come and look here, and then you move it like that, and then you make sure it clicks.
Ensure that the diagram is fully opened.
Yeah. It's really opened. Yeah, it is open.
Look through the eyepiece with one eye. Meanwhile, adjust the mirror under the stage to ensure that the maximum light cannot pass through. The circular area seen is referred to as the field of view.
Yes. Then you place the mirror in the way that it will reflect right, and then you look. The circular part that you are seeing under the microscope, that is called a field of view.
Okay. Place the slide containing the specimen on the stage to click into position. Make sure that it is center of field of view.
This is our specimen, and then you put it.
Yeah, what we see inside our field of view. As this is the animal cell, we put it into our clips. We must see what is inside the field of view. Yeah, exactly. This is an illustration what we see from the field of view. Of an animal cell. This is our cell membrane. This dot part, you see the cytoplasm, cytosol, and this is the nucleus, the middle part. Cytoplasm. Yeah. Again, look through the eyepiece when adjusting the mirror under the stage to ensure that specific light passes through the specimen, exactly what we have done here.
And then use the coarse adjustment knob to bring the raw objective lens to the lowest point viewing through the eyepiece. Turn coarse adjustment knob gently until the specimen comes into focus.
And that marks the end of our discussion. I've been Patience Mogori.
Christmas, Gina.
Thanks for coming. Keep it a remote TV where we
watch and learn.